Bora embroidery remains a popular technique for cutting holes in fabric to produce an effect similar to lace. This video provides advice on how to approach boring with Embroidery Studio. Without stitch testing, however, we can only provide the theory. Bora digitizing is a difficult skill to master. You'll need to experiment with your machine and stitch width and spacing settings to achieve reliable results. Boras are often knife attachments, which are offset from the main needle. For Tajima and Dahao formats, the offset is fixed at plus or minus 12 millimeters. Another method is to use a special needle that acts as a knife. In this case, there is no offset. Select the format for the target machine you are using. For instance, Tajima, Baruden, SWF, etc. The needle position of the bora and its offset value are specified as part of the machine format definition. Some machines automatically adjust the offset when a bora in function is encountered. These require a value of zero. This too should be part of the machine format definition, but you may need to adjust it. In the stitch list, you will see bora in and bora out functions whenever the bora knife is engaged. Diamond shapes represent bora cuts on the fabric. Size indicates depth of cut. Any offset required occurs when exporting to production file. Whether you are digitizing for bora knife or needle, the technique is the same. Ensure penetrations is on, otherwise it will be all jumps. Open the stitch list to visualize what's happening at the stitch level. Digitize a stabilizing run around the bora hole. This helps prevent fabric tear. Click the bora's icon. A machine function is inserted to indicate the change from stitching to boring. Using the run tool, digitize cutting lines. For a round hole, two intersecting lines are sufficient. Reduce run length to 1 or 1.5 millimeters to place bora penetrations closer together. This ensures a clean cut. Because the boring knife does not require tie-in or tie-off stitches, deactivate these functions. Click boras again to deselect the function. This returns you to normal stitching. Bora holes are generally stabilized with zigzag to prevent fraying. Digitize around the hole with column A or, if you have it, the ring tool. Select the object and change to zigzag stitch if not already selected. Turn off underlay and adjust stitch length to around 3 mm. Place the inside edge close to the hole center so it wraps the fabric. As a shortcut, duplicate the zigzag object and apply satin stitch. Again, ensure underlay is turned off. Try experimenting with other styles of cover stitching. For a more open style, try zigzag on its own by decreasing stitch spacing to around 1 mm. For a more organic look, try applying hand stitch effect to either zigzag or satin cover stitching. Pagadi or string stitch may also provide interesting cover for boring holes. For an oval hole, digitize a single cutting line. Here we see an experimental square bora hole design. With sharp corners, stitching tends to pull fabric inward. We try to compensate for this by angling corners outwards. Bear in mind that before putting any boring into production, everything needs to be carefully stitch tested, edited, and tested again. Once you have designed and tested boring holes that work, you can save them as custom motifs for reuse. Make sure Remove Other Functions is turned off to preserve cutting lines. Once you have set up a library of boreholes, these are available for use with the Use Motif tool. The advantage of this technique is that boring holes can be easily scaled and rotated into position. Check, however, that scaling does not affect the ratio of knife cut to zigzag and cover stitching. When it comes to actual production, boreholes are usually cut in groups for faster production. Individual motifs appear as grouped objects. Ungroup them and resequence components as needed. The components need to be sequenced for bore cuts to occur in neat, close groupings. Combined effects. Typically, you'll want to combine boring holes with other stitch types and effects, such as stem stitch, contour, and motif runs. Pagadi or string stitch can also be used to good effect with bore designs as custom motif runs. If your machine supports it, you can combine boring with cording or tape embroidery. You may also be able to combine bore holes with appliqué objects, such as floral motifs. Turn on TrueView to see the finished result. Export the machine file corresponding to your selected machine format, for instance, Tajima, DST, or SWF, EBD. When exporting to Tajima or Baruden machine file, boring functions are encoded as color changes. These allow the machine to switch to the boring attachment. The machine must be correctly programmed. In addition to color change codes, the software adds a vertical offset of 12 mm as jumps wherever it encounters a borer in or borer out function. These are interpreted on the machine as borer in, stop code with minus 12 mm offset, borer out, stop code with plus 12 mm offset. For Tajima DST, the needle bar sequence is set on the control panel by the machine operator. If the machine bar sequence is incorrect, the fabric is ruined. As the production worksheet shows, the needle bars are indicated in the color sequence.